Thanks for joining us here on the web. The man accused of attacking the Mason police chief headed to court today. Hello, everybody. I'm Melinda Davenport. Russell Monblow faces several charges after police say he attacked the chief, even hitting him with a metal chair. Ray Brewer has that story.
A day after being returned to New Hampshire, Russell Monblow found himself in Merrimack Circuit Court. Last Friday night, police say Monblow was a passenger in a car and assaulted Mason's police chief, Barry Hutchins, during a traffic stop. One of the felony complaints alleges that Monblow threw a metal chair similar to this at the chief, hitting him. The blow serious enough so that the chief suffered internal injuries. The prosecution asked that bail be set at $50,000 cash.
In addition, at the time of the incident, he had two current bench warrants out for him. He did go back to Massachusetts where he had to be extradited, or he had to be sought extradition to get him back to New Hampshire, Your Honor.
During his struggle with the chief, police say that Monblow also tried to pull the chief's coat over the chief's head and pushed the chief. Those alleged actions led to Monblow being charged with two counts of simple assault. Monblow is also charged with resisting arrest for fleeing into the woods. And the prosecution noted this was not the first time Monblow has done something like this, saying the defendant has a lengthy criminal record.
Including numerous defaults, several simple assaults, at least four possession of drugs, a shoplifting, several resisting arrests, and a violation of probation conviction, Your Honor.
The judge granted the prosecution's request and set bail at $50,000.
That was Ray Brewer reporting. An Aetna man appeared in court today accused of writing a threatening Facebook post against the families of Hanover police officers. Prosecutors say David Barr's post specifically targeted the children of Hanover officers, and police cruisers were sent to area schools as a precaution. Barr was taken into custody at his job at Dartmouth College. Prosecutors say the motive for the threats appears to stem from a recent DWI charge. A public hearing today in Concord on the legalization of marijuana. New Hampshire's House has already approved legalizing small amounts of marijuana. The bill, which allows people over 21 to have up to an ounce of the drug, will go back to the House for another to vote after today's hearing. We'll have much more on this debate coming up at 5 and 6. Well, the Super Bowl is just days away now, and police are warning fans about counterfeit merchandise. Federal officials say they've already seized $20 million worth of fake gear and tickets. That's up 15% from last year. Investigators say if the price seems too good to be true, well, it probably is.
The material here is plastic. It shouldn't be. That's all plastic. The stitching is off. See how the stitching is off?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Very poor quality.
Homeland Security investigate reports of fakes. Confiscated items are either destroyed or donated if the trademark holder agrees to it. Well, starting tonight at 5, a potential breakthrough in treating nut allergies. What doctors did that led 80% of children in one study safely eat peanuts. And a new dating service claims to have the answer to people who are too busy for love. Part-time relationships. You want to hear about this unusual approach. Well, that does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everyone.